take a moment and imagine this. Home being bombed. The dust is cleared. You get up only to discover that some of the members are dead and some survive. Those who remain fear for their life, escaping in the middle of the night, leaving personal belongings behind to go to a foreign country. Your daily life is ruptured. What I've just described to you are the obstacles refugees have faced, overcome in order to survive. Good morning, parents, students, staff members, 2016, and Director of Rome. My name is Nyabel. Welcome you to my senior talk. For those of you who don't know what a refugee is, please, allow me to explain. A refugee is a person who is outside of their native country. They can't return to their home due to the fear of persecution because of their race, religion, nationality, political opinion, or in a particular social group. Please watch this video further explaining the refugee crisis around the world.
The flood of humanity making its way across Europe is mostly made up of refugees from the war zones that Iraq and Syria. They are the father who carries his daughter on his shoulders because back home, she was his little prince and he just wants to give her that back again. The mother with the law degree who cries every single time she talks or even thinks about her children that she had to leave home, making the trek on her own in hopes that they will be able to join her. They are youth, students, groups of young men who also want to bring their families over to Europe, who are looking for opportunities that no longer exist in their respective countries. Things like jobs, education, and just the chance of living a dignified and respect life. There are people fleeing violence or they have no control. People who don't want to die, who don't want to watch their children die. So yes, parents make possible decision of bringing over their little ones, their babies, because as they keep telling us, if they were to stay back home, they believe that they would end up dead. So why not take the chance and truck it to Europe? There are people from as far away as Myanmar and Afghanistan, from various African nations who are abject poverty, corrupt and oppressive regimes. There are people of different backgrounds from all walks of life who share one thing in common, a belief, a dream that Europe will offer a future, any future.
The world is experiencing a crisis more severe than anything seen in decades. Make no mistake, the current crisis is global. There are 19 million who are refugees. Let that sink in for a minute. 19 million children who are refugees. In total, there are 59.5 million refugees worldwide. This is an alarming number. When Director first introduced the service learning experience last year, I was beyond excited. I already knew what different organizations I wanted to be a part of. I knew I wanted to talk to those that came from a similar background of that to my own. That is the refugee community here in San Diego. I first contacted the International Rescue Committee, RRC, and I looked through the different requirements, but soon as I was ineligible due to my age. It took quite some time. It did. We found the perfect organization, and that is the San Diego Refugee Wing Organization. They are located at the Barra Ella School in City Heights. I tutor every Tuesday and Thursday afternoon. Being with the children, being able to have the opportunity to make a difference in children's lives privilege. Being with the children reminded me of stories that my brother would name. Allow me to tell you a story about my brother. He He was born into a loving family on April 25th, 1988 in Ethiopia. Things, however, went wrong because the Second Sudanese Civil War will soon change his life. Our parents stopped in the United States and were forced to leave him behind. He was left with our grandparents, who lived in a hut found within a surrounding. He was only 7 years old. He would help our grandparents with whatever they needed, which included household chores and taking care of the goats and cows. He did not have an opportunity to attend school due to the destruction of the Second Sudanese War. Things changed in 1997. He got on a plane with other family members, started his journey to the United States. When he got off the plane, he was shocked. For the first time in his life, he was surrounded by, He was surrounded by different cultures from around. Because he did not know English and her complexion, he was teased on a daily basis. Not only that, but he had to learn a new language, which was difficult. However, through work and determination, he was able to speak English and to graduate high school. He is now in college getting ready to graduate with his bachelor's in security. I am grateful for his sacrifice, hearing his story, and him allowing me to recite this story with all of you today. His story has motivated me to complete my service learning, supporting refugees, and not only dedicating my time, but my love to the San Diego Refugee Tutoring Program. The San Diego Refugee Tutoring Program is a program that touched my heart. I was able to say that I gave my heart dedication to this program. I was able to say that I was a superhero in these kids' lives because I was able to help them learn and to mentor them with whatever they needed. That is what a superhero is, right, Isabel G? There are two girls in particular that have impacted my life and have left their imprint in my heart forever. Their names Hagase and Annette. They both have totally different personalities. I mean, don't we all? But these two girls are so unique and their personalities shine bright when I get to tutor them. Hagase is a fourth grader who attends Ibarra Elementary School. She loves math, and I mean loves math. She's a young Burmese child that excels in drawing on her spare time. Being able to witness the passion she has for drawing is a privilege because she is so young yet creates beautiful artwork. Then there's Annette, who's a sixth grader who also is about an elementary school. She is from Uganda, Africa, and only came to the United States only a year and a half ago. Her passion is writing, but poetry in particular. Being able to witness her passion for writing is because she only came to the United States a year and a half ago and developed such a writing. The San Diego Refugee Tutoring Center, where eager to learn students come get the help that they desperately need due to language barriers at home. S- Similar to how Director of Senior PM, the IRC established a branch for refugee students to come get the help that they desperately need. I typically get to the refugee tutoring center earlier than most volunteers. So I start myself in, they wipe me down the tables, and all four tutors. Once I am done with that responsibility, children begin to arrive. So I go down and I help by signing and handing them their profile sheets, which includes each child's age, grade level, background, and areas where they are academically struggling. Once everyone has their profile sheets and everyone is signed, we pair them up with a tutor. Tutoring sessions typically last about 90 minutes. Within those 90 minutes, each tutor and each student get to participate in math and literacy games. The reason they get to participate in math and literacy games is to help their love for learning and to bring more fun and more joy into the learning. Once the tutorings are over, we all clean up and we all wait for the children to go. Before or after each student finishes their homework, they get a chance to tap into their artistic talent. The art room opens every Tuesday afternoon. Each child receives a visual journal. In the visual journal, they get to express their feelings, emotions, and thoughts. As you can see in this picture, this was drawn by one of the children that I tutored. Here, the girl I tutored, and her cousin. Over the past 25 weeks, I've got the honor to experience the uniqueness of the San Diego Refugee Organization. It was one of the best experiences of my life to give back to our future generations, our future doctors, our future nurses, our engineers. Please take a look at my service learning over the past 25 weeks.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. Know that something bad and something bad hides behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regret. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.
Everything that I wanted, and it was more than
As you may see in my video, I've made an impact, a difference in children's lives. I would like to say that I made a difference in these kids' lives by not only being a mentor, but being. I was able to help them transition from one to another, and that is what made me, at the end of the day, tutoring with them. I did not only impact their lives, but they impacted mine to make me want to make a change in our community. There are many things that we can do to make a difference. What you can do is go to the Refugee Tutoring website and volunteer time. If you're able to do so, you could donate snacks or money to help the program thrive more than it is already. Thank you for coming to my senior talk, and this concludes my senior talk.